Hi everybody, welcome to Super Duper Kitchen. Today we are going to see the recipe for Aloo Paneer Matar. It is one of the famous North Indian recipes that can be easily made at home. We are not going to use any fresh cream or we are not going to make it in a restaurant style. It is a simple home food. Now let's see how to make this recipe. For this we need garlic cloves, green chilies, ginger. And to grind this, we are going to add 2 tablespoons of chopped onions. And a little quantity of water to make it to a fine paste. This is the main masala for this gravy. Ginger, garlic, chili paste is ready. Keep it aside. Then take ripened tomatoes, chop them into big chunks and grind them to a fine puree. Tomato puree is ready, keep it aside. Take a kadai or a pan, add butter. Add cumin seeds. So you can note that for all the North Indian gravies and recipes, we will be using jeera for the tatka. Saute them well until you get nice aroma. It is also good for digestion. At this stage, add ginger garlic chili paste and keep it in low flame and saute them well. Otherwise, it will stick to the bottom. Once the raw smell goes off, add the finely chopped onions. Saute until they turn translucent in color. At this stage, add ground tomato puree and mix everything together well. To this, add required amount of salt. Turmeric powder. Red chili powder, garam masala powder, and mix everything together well. This can also be called as a North Indian base for all the gravies. Most of the gravies will have this step. And I have already pressure cooked the potatoes and have peeled them and chopped them into big chunks. So add the cooked potatoes and boiled peas into this gravy. Add some water and allow them to cook so that the peas and the potatoes will absorb all the masala and they will get blended with the gravy. Finally, once they start to boil, add the chopped or diced paneer and mix everything together well. Aloo paneer matar is ready. As I said, this is a very simple home style gravy. Finally, garnish them with fresh coriander leaves. Chop them into fine pieces and garnish them. Have it with fulka, roti, naan, kulcha, anything of your choice. It's one of the common gravies made in North Indian homes. Please do try this recipe at home and give me your feedback. See you all in another wonderful recipe in Super Duper Kitchen. Until then, it's bye from Nirinjana Shankar Narayanan.